Hello everyone. Today we'll be covering some tips and tricks in FormIt. Let's begin with your cursor placement. For tools like Orbit, Pan, and Zoom, the position of your cursor determines the focus point for these tools, allowing you to navigate to and around specific points in space. Let me show you how. For the Orbit tool, wherever your cursor is when you start the tool is the center point around which the view will orbit. If we wanted to see this plaza from all angles, begin at the center of the area and notice how, as we rotate, it never goes out of view. If we place a cube and begin at the center of it, the cube never leaves the view, but if we begin at the top of the view, the cube is immediately lost. The Pan tool functions similarly. Wherever you click to begin is the center of the view you can pan around. If I click near the cube, notice I am dragging from that point around. If I click near the building to the far left, notice that as I drag, the cursor remains near that building point as I pan. When you engage the Zoom tool, wherever you click and drag from or scroll to is the point that the view will zoom into or out of. Wherever there is a dimension displayed on screen from any edit or creation tool, you can always type tab or click inside of it to edit the value. This is particularly useful for trying several dimensions in succession to see which will work best. Some tools, like non-uniform scale, present multiple dimension boxes. Tab will bring you to the primary dimension box, which is the scale percentage, but you can access any of the others by clicking into them directly. Under the settings menu, the pre-selection highlight can be turned on or off. While modeling, you typically want it on to show what you are about to select, but when walking through a model or reviewing it with a client, the pre-selection highlight can get distracting, so you can turn it off here or use the shortcut PS. The next helpful tip is to use the group edit tool or shortcut GE. This bypasses the parent group, and with pre-selection highlight on, you will see that no matter how many levels a group is nested, it will highlight individually, and when you select it, you are taken directly to that model element. This is especially convenient when you're editing a nested group and want to edit some other nested group that may be in a completely different context. Additionally, when you're done editing a group, the F key will finish the edit mode and bring you back to the main sketch, without having to hit escape repeatedly to navigate back out of the nested hierarchy. Hiding group context is often something you want to toggle back and forth between as you develop a model. Sometimes you want all elements outside of the group you are editing to show in the view so you can use them to align to or use the eyedropper tool to reference a material. But other times the context might get in the way. Hitting the shortcut H or going to the settings menu to check on or off the hide group context can assist in this visibility. Hiding group context also improves performance if you just need to edit a small part of a larger model. Hiding the context can also eliminate objects that could be in the way of seeing or modifying geometry, and can help with smoother navigation if the camera gets stuck inside of context geometry. When hovering over an element, the tab key can be pressed to smart select other elements depending on the situation. If you want to grab all of the segments of a line or a boundary on a surface, hover over one and press tab. When creating a sweep, the tab key can be used to grab the entire path if it's more than one line. The tab key will also select all coplanar 2D edge loops on a face of a solid. If you hover over a group and press tab, all instances of that group will highlight in the model to show you where they are. This can be very helpful if you are going to edit a group, but you want to make sure it doesn't have any other instances in the model before your edits. If you want to batch, move, copy, or paint all identical groups, this tool is very helpful. If you have copied an element multiple times, say a rectangle across a wall to create windows, if you hover over one and press tab, all of the copies will highlight and can be manipulated in tandem, similar to if they were all instances of the same group. Once pre-selected, you can click to confirm the selection, at which point you can use the drag face tool on all of them, or other tools like move. If you extrude that rectangle to subtract from the wall and create openings, you can then hover over the faces in the resulting opening and tab select to grab all of the same size faces and manipulate them all at once. Tab selection is especially useful for symmetrically resizing objects that have faces of the same size on either side. This is also helpful if you wanted to paint the interior all the same material, or if you want to readjust the thickness of walls by grabbing all of the interior faces and moving them inward. When extruding solid geometry, FormIt's modeler does not get stuck on openings, complex shapes, or intersections at angles. As long as the solid is watertight, you can drag a face through space, cutting away whatever parts of the solid it passes, which can be very helpful if you need to break apart a single solid into multiples, or eliminate entire sections of a solid with one action. FormIt heals and merges solids automatically, cleaning up any coplanar lines or faces that are created in the extrusion operations, and flipping faces as necessary to make sure the solid remains watertight. Speaking of cleanup, if you have edges that were split by previous operations and are still coplanar, you can heal them into a single edge again by simply deleting the inner vertices. Plugins also offer some good tricks to speed up workflows and improve efficiency. Of them, the Properties Plus plugin will display how many instances of the group you are editing, and therefore how many instances will be affected by changes in the current context. You can also select an instance to see the same information about the selection. Within this palette, you can also rename all of the instances of the group at once by changing the name input. If you have a mix of object types selected, you can use the Selection Minus button to remove objects by type. Back in the Plugin Manager, if we toggle the Manage Camera plugin on, we are given a readout of our current view, height above the nearest level and height above ground, which you can type into to adjust. This is helpful if you want all of your views to be at eye level, no matter which model level they are on. When pre-selecting objects, the spacebar can be used to depth select, so you can select an object that is being obstructed. For instance, if we create a primitive cube, and copy and paste that cube into the exact same place, and group the copy, there is now no default way to select the parts of the cube originally placed, occupying the same space, because the group we created will take precedence. If you press spacebar, you can depth select or grab objects behind others, despite the fact that they are colliding. You will need pre-selection highlight on to be able to see this. That's it for FormIt tips and tricks. Be sure to check out more videos on the FormIt YouTube channel.